Okay, I'm gonna try. I was sent this video by the rider of this horse, and I'm gonna play this video on my computer and then try to make a video so I can talk and explain what I'm seeing and what's going on, good and bad here. So I'm gonna go ahead and start this video, and some of the things that I'm gonna talk about is this isn't to make fun of the rider, it's not to make fun of the trainer. It's to give my opinion on what I'm seeing and the bad and the good and the signals that this horse is sending out and the signals that this horse is trying to send. So I'm going to go ahead and start this. Things I want you to look for is when I'm talking about the horse, look at the horse's head position. Look at the way it's looking around. Look at the way his head's being taken away. Look at the way it's being... what's happening here is you've got multiple people on the ground putting multiple pressure on a horse. One leading, one has a rope tied to the horse's foot, and you have a rider trying to learn how to balance and ride. This is way too much for a horse to deal with. It's way too much for a rider to deal with, and it's way too much for anybody on the ground to deal with. Because when you have these four things, and you have more than those four things, you've got other people opening gates, you've got dogs barking, you got other people standing around, and you have two people on the ground, and you have a person in the saddle, and not one of them can predict what the other one's going to do. And then you throw in a horse in the middle of this, and you have a great big boiling pot of soup that's about to get thrown on somebody. And you can probably figure out who is going to get thrown on here. So I did a video earlier about don't ever get on a horse with somebody leading a horse without you having reins or ability to control this horse. Now there's so much going on here, and I'm going to be trying to talk so fast, and you're going to be trying to see what I see. So I may go back and run this video twice. It's about 6 minutes. That way you'll have the first time, and then I can go back, and if I miss something, maybe I'll say something I didn't say again. We'll see how it goes, but I'm going to go ahead and start this video here and see how we're doing. So notice the guy in the front, and again I'm going to put a link of this in the description so you can watch the video in case the clarity isn't real good here, because again I'm filming off a computer screen. Okay, so we have a guy leading a horse with a lead rope, pulling on a horse. We have a person sitting on a horse with no reins. All this person doing sitting on a horse is hanging on. The horse is confused. He's trying to balance. Look how his back leg's parked out. Why is his back leg parked out? Because you got a guy following him with a rope tied to his leg. Now, I got no problem with tying a rope to a horse's rear leg and trying to teach him to sack out. I got a big problem trying to do that when you got a rider that can't balance sitting on him, and you got another guy pulling on front of him. You got another guy standing behind you in the ring watching. You got a dog. If you hear the video to this, there's a dog barking. There's gates open. This horse is being overwhelmed with what's going on. Not to mention the horse looks a little young and a little small. I don't know whether it's underfed or it's strong or it's a baby. But this horse is not ready for a rider. Look at that head. He's paying attention to so many things. That it's just so unfair to set this horse up. And this horse is totally set up to fail, and you're going to see this as this thing progresses. Now right here, he took the rope off the back leg. If you notice the guy with the rope behind him now, they took it off the back leg. So that relieved one pressure. But you still have that guy in the ring winding up the rope. That horse is still worried about this third person behind him now. So now he's got two eyes, and he's trying to focus on the rider, on the guy leading him, on the guy rolling the rope behind him, on the other people running around. There's no way this horse is in any position to learn. He's not focusing on the rider, and he's not focusing on the guy on the ground. So now he's resisting, now he's getting popped, now he's getting training. Obviously the horse doesn't know what the guy on the ground wants because he's throwing his head. So that's telling me the guy isn't ready to move. Now notice the girl's balancing on the horse here. When this horse kind of moves, look at the balance. Look, I think her stirrups are too long. See, her legs aren't bent the way they should be, so she can't really use her legs to balance. See how she's bending her knees now? Notice her knees are bending. The horse is going in a circle. He's being pulled around. She doesn't have her heels down. She's off balance. She's hanging onto the horn because she don't have any reins. She's leaning forward to pet him. I'm okay with that, letting the horse know. But this horse is nowhere He's telling me a million ways to one. I'm not ready for this. You're overwhelming me. There's too much going on. You're pulling on me. I'm confused. I got this person on my back. Is she trying to tackle me? I don't know how to balance. She don't know how to balance. You're pulling on me. What do I... This horse is in total confusion. This is so unfair. You're totally setting this horse up to fail. He's ready to blow. His head's going high. He's not following his head. He hasn't been taught how to follow his head. He hasn't been taught to give to pressure. He's actually crossing over, not too bad on his back feet. He's changing directions. But look at the rider. The rider's off balance, leaning. Look at the rider leaning. That means she's not balanced. If she was balanced, she wouldn't be leaning. She's kind of off balance. You can see her leaning. See her knees bent. See how she's kind of, see how she's off balance. See the horse panicking. See that quick running movement. This is all bad. And this is confusing the horse. The horse isn't learning. Now, the guy who's doing this has a speaker on his head, and he's being a clinician, and he's talking. But I don't care what he's saying, and I don't care if he's being able to control his horse. He's not the one taking the risk here. The person taking the risk is the person sitting on the horse. And the horse is learning bad lessons, because if the person that's sitting on him falls off, jumps off, or gets bucked off, the horse learned a bad lesson. The guy on the ground doesn't get hurt. The horse may not get hurt physically, but he gets hurt in his progress of learning. He ends up learning he can get a rider off. This does not appear like this horse has had a rider in a long time. This person riding this horse is probably a little big for this horse. If the horse was better balanced and maybe had been carrying, if it learned to carry somebody smaller, then it would be able to carry a bigger person. But trying to learn how to carry a big person that doesn't know how to ride, that's off balance, that's bending her legs and knees, all that creates problems. See this horse prancing? See that tail? Look at that head sticking out. That's telling me this horse is nervous. That horse would be blowing up if he didn't have this guy on a lead rope. If this guy on the lead rope was not holding this horse's head and pulling this horse would run off and buck and panic. Plus, the rider would fall off. The only reason the rider is staying on is because the horse is being slowed and controlled by the guy on the ground. If the guy on the ground was not controlling this horse and slowing the horse down, this horse would run off, and the person on top doesn't have balance and would fall off. Now, you're going to say, oh, he's only saying that because later on in the film, this dummy lets the horse go and the person falls off. I didn't have to see this. When I saw this, right now, this guy is tying this rope to the horn. He's leaving this horse with no reins, nothing on, with a rider that doesn't have balance, with a scared horse that's already demonstrated that it gets nervous and runs off. It's already demonstrated that it needs control of that rein to slow it down and to bring it back. It's nervous, it's scared, looking around. It doesn't know what to do. Now it's walking off saying, nobody's giving me direction. I don't know what to do. I don't know which way to go. Nobody's telling me. I'll just walk this way. I'm not sure. I'm confused. Look at the head. Look at those ears. That horse is totally confusion. That horse is totally building up anxiety right now. That tail is stiff. That tail sticking out. Total anxiety. Total fear. Look at that head movement. Look at that quick movement away from the person. Get away. Pressure. I'm nervous. Look at that off balance. Look at the knees bending. This is all bad for this horse. Look at that. Falling off. The horse knows this. The horse says, uh-oh, this person's trying to tackle me. The horse gets scared. It runs off. Watch the rider. Bye-bye. Oops. Oh. You don't hear this, but this guy says this horse never bucked before. This horse never bucked before. Look at this horse. This horse is scared. It still doesn't know what to do. The horse is still running around looking, what do I do? He doesn't know what happened. He doesn't know he hurt this rider. He doesn't know that he could have killed this person. Look at those ears and that head. He's confused. He's nervous. So now what happens? A predator with a plastic bag that he's obviously scared of starts stalking him. Okay? So the horse is nervous. The horse is scared. The guy gets this rope. And now what does he do? Does he secure the horse? Does he take the horse back to where he's comfortable? Does he do something to make the horse build a little confidence? Hell no. He takes a freaking plastic bag and scares the shit out of the horse. Look at this horse. You think this horse is learning? You think this horse is getting anything out of this except I can't trust people? Not only when somebody's on my back do they jump off and leave me to handle myself, but after the person jumps off, this other dude chased me with a plastic bag. Somebody's going to see this and say, oh, he's sacking him out, Rick. He's teaching him how to be freaking scared of the bag. He's not helping that horse at all. That was freaking horrible, people. There's so many things that went wrong on this that I'm going to turn on the audio so you can hear a little bit what's going on. But again, I'm going to put a link to this. So if you want to go watch this and hear the audio, and now that you've seen it without hearing the audio, you're going to be looking at it with a critical eye and a different eye, seeing things. You're going to know what's going to happen. Now when you hear the audio, you're going to know this guy is crazy. Why is this person? Now this person wrote me and said, I made a mistake and it was done. I hope others can learn from this. So I applaud her for giving me this and allowing me to kind of critique this, because I normally don't like doing this. If it works, I may do it more, but a lot of people don't want to stick their neck out and kind of say, hey, I'm a dummy. I made some mistakes. And that's okay. We've all done it. I've been there. But in this particular video, there were so many mistakes by so many people, and everybody's going to say, damn, the writer got the worst end of the deal. Actually, if the writer didn't get hurt, you know, there's an old saying, green on green equals black on blue, equals black and blue. Okay, a green rider, which you can tell by the way this person has no balance, bending her legs, going to fetal position, staying off center, can't control her balance, reins too long. This person is a green rider. The horse, green horse, ears up, heads up, has to be controlled, runs off, gets panicky, doesn't know what to do, not given direction, fearful, untrustworthy, untrusting. He lacks confidence. Why? Because the person handling him hasn't taught him how to be confident, hasn't set him up to succeed. What they've done is they set him up on a path of failure. And guess what? The horse went right where they led him, to failure. So green on green equals black and blue. A green rider on a green horse will equal black and blue bruises. So the rider now has black and blue bruises. Well, I see this a little worse than that. Because if the only thing the rider got was black and blue, that's not what the horse got. The horse got horrible lessons that he now is going to carry and is going to take so much work to undo this. It's going to take 10 times as long. It's going to take 10 times the training. It's going to take 10 times the mistakes, because this horse now knows when a rider gets on me, if I run fast, the rider gets off. If I panic, when a rider starts losing her balance and falling off, I need to run off so the rider doesn't tackle me or pull me down. I need to get rid of the rider when they start losing their balance and tries to pull me off balance, because I think they may be trying to tackle me. All these things the horse learned, and now it has to be unlearned. Now the horse has a reputation. A few minutes ago, it had a reputation of never bucking. Now it bucked, and it kicked out when it bucked. Now it threw a rider. Now it has a reputation. Now you have a horse with a past and no future because of dumb people doing dumb things and setting a horse up to fail. These are the kind of things that I see every day at every barn I go to. So you people that want to get on here and go, well, I don't know where you're watching, Rich. I never see that. And blah, 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 blah. Shut the hell up and get off my channel. I'm telling you, this goes on every day. And if you don't want to believe that, and you want to think that you're special and that your barn is special and that this never happens, then don't waste your time watching my videos. Because I'm telling you, you're full of crap if you think that. You don't know what you're talking about, and you haven't been around enough horses. I go to many different barns in many different places. This is a normal routine. Watch videos on YouTube. Go to barns. Go to gymkhanas. You see this all the time. People, this guy has a wireless mic on. He's out here doing a clinic. He's talking like he knows what he's doing. And you know what? He may know what he's doing, but he ain't risking his life on that horse. He ain't climbing on that horse with no reins and letting that horse run around. Okay, so he may not be the smartest horse guy, but he's not the dumbest one either. Okay, now the person that got on there, you can say the rider is dumb for getting on there, but that's not the case either. The rider trusted somebody that because she didn't know. The rider was looking to someone experienced. I'm always telling you people, if you run around asking questions on the internet and looking for any trainer and begging people to teach you, you put your life in their hands. You allow them to take your life and to hurt you, to teach your horse bad lessons. You allow them to hurt your horse because you don't know. And that's why I tell people, take responsibility, learn, read, watch my videos, and develop a critical eye. Develop a critical mind that says, this isn't right. Listen to the horse. All these things help you succeed, people. It helps your horse succeed. But too many people are too damn busy. They're looking for the easy way. They want to watch Flicka and Black Beauty, and they think that every horse is going to love and protect them if they get the right breeding and the right color with the right saddle and the right pad, and then they listen to somebody that puts their life in danger. If I'd have been watching this, I probably wouldn't have got involved because I've learned long ago not to get involved. But I would have guaranteed you, whoever I was standing next to, I'd have went, this girl's going to end up getting bucked or thrown into the fence. I got $100. I could make a mint if I open up a casino on people doing stupid things with horses, predicting what can happen. I would make a million. I can go to any barn and predict 90% of the shit that's going to happen. And people be like, oh, that's not true. Not at my barn. Everybody's good and we use bits and we whatever. People, this is a learning channel. You look at this video and this happens every day. It may not happen the same way and you may not be able to see it because you're not looking at it. But I'm telling you, I could have easily made this video and talked about how nice this horse is, and you see this guy taking his time with this horse, and you see the horse is just moving his feet, and he's releasing the limit. This guy's doing everything right, and this rider, look at her, she's trying, and even though she's losing her balance, she's sitting on there very nice, and look at that horse, he's looking around, but he's following the lead rope, and he's doing what he's supposed to. This is really good, people. Look at how good this horse is learning, and this guy on the ground is showing good leadership. He's petting the horse. He's really showing the horse good leadership, and this horse is learning some really good lessons. And see how the horse threw his head there? You notice the guy on the ground, he gave good direction, and he led the horse, and he's making the horse move. All this is really, really good. And you see the rider? She's petting the horse. That's really good, and she's reassuring the horse. And they're both learning. This is just perfect training, people. I just can't believe how everything is done right. And the horse world is wonderful. And this is why you need a good professional trainer, who's somebody who knows what they're doing. And this lady got some help. And she got her a trainer. And she didn't try to do it on herself. And she got someone else who knows what they're doing. This lady is really, really just doing all the right stuff. See, she's learning how to trot. And you see how she's learning how to keep her balance, and this, the horse is following the person on the ground. See him using his feet and his mind. He's controlling the horse. He's not letting the horse run off, and just, this is just really great horsemanship right here, people. This is what you need to do. Okay, come to my clinic and pay me or hire me as a trainer, because this is what I'll do. I'll do everything right, and they're in a nice round pen. It's a secure area. Look at the horse walking all calmly. Look how nice the horse is walking. This is because everything's being done right. This is so good. Notice the girl who's not, she's not kicking the horse. She doesn't have a bit on. She's not hurting the horse. See her relax and smiling. This is so good and wonderful and beautiful. This is just really, really perfect horsemanship. And this is how people need to train their horse. You girls out there, listen to me. You go find you a professional trainer who knows what he's doing, like this guy. And you pay him so he can keep you safe. And you listen to him, because look at the way he knows what he's doing. See how he's controlling this horse? This guy knows what he's doing. He's a smart guy. He really knows what he's doing. And this owner, this rider, is a smart rider, because she didn't try to do this on her own. She got somebody smart, and she's listening to him. And she's going to take his advice, and she's learning from somebody that knows what they're doing. Because, I mean, look at this guy. He's really just doing all these great and wonderful things. This is what trainers do, people. This is why you need to go out and pay a trainer. This is why you need to go out. Okay, we're going to end this here, because this guy did everything right. Okay, so you go out and you buy his video and you get him to do your clinics, and you get trained by this guy, because he's doing a really great job. Okay, we'll end the video here. We'll see you later. Bye-bye. And now if I turn this off, you people wouldn't have a clue. Most people wouldn't have, people that watch my video would be like, what the hell are you talking about, Rick? There's all kind of shit going wrong. People that never watched my video, if I'd have just went and talked that nice lovey-dovey crap and gave you all this feel-good information that most people are going to give you, you would have thought things were going fine. and you would have probably listened to my advice because it sounded good and it sounded nice. And Rick wasn't being negative or mean. He was being nice and it sounded so much better, Rick. Yeah, okay. You want all that nicey stuff? Then this is what you get. Because watch what happens when you get nicey-nicey, okay? Instead of calling it like I see it and correcting and saying all the bad and mean stuff, I could have predicted what's happening. Instead, I gave you this feel-good stuff. You don't know what's going to happen. Look how this girl pays. Here comes hard lesson. Okay, that was a good lesson. Nice, Horsey. That's a great lesson, Horsey. This was Horsey Lesson 101. This horse was trained to do this to teach people not to get on horses without having reins. So this horse did exactly what he was supposed to do. Good boy. Okay? It all depends on your frame of reference, people. You can either listen to the first half of this, where I told you what was going wrong. You can listen to the second half, where I made it look like everything was sweet, pink, puffy cream puffs. Or you can learn and develop your own critical eye and develop your own mindset and know what's right and wrong and understand and read a horse and realize when your horse is telling you he's scared, nervous, and insecure, you know you got to pull back. This horse right here, in case you didn't know, is scared. Okay, everybody's going, how do you know what a horse is scared? This is what you know. The horse is pulling, he's fearful, he's running, he's looking for escape, he's panicking. He's not learning. He's not being desensitized from that bag. He's being chased and scared of it. That is improper sacking out, people. This guy's irritating me. I got to turn him off. I'm getting a freaking headache. All right. That's... we'll end that there. Maybe I'll go back to just where the horse runs off and we'll get one more falling since that's kind of like the best part. Well, it's not the best part for the rider. It's the best part for me to make my point. Notice the guy has a plastic bag? Notice the plastic bag in here, so he brings more fear into the horse. Notice the off balance. Notice the hanging onto the horn. Notice the no reins. Notice the tail. Notice the head. Notice the run. Watch this head go high. Watch this tail go up. Look at this run. Look at this panic. Buck. Kick. Poor horse. Now I was saying good horse for that horse has some bad lessons, and he learned some bad stuff, and that's too bad. Okay? I'll end that there. I hope that helps. I went on a couple different areas trying to explain some things. This is why I want people to learn. This is why I don't want you putting your life or your horse into somebody that you have no clue on what they know what they're doing. And just because a guy can grab a horse and chase it with a plastic bag or control his head does not mean he's a horseman. Does not mean that the horse has properly been prepared for you to get on it. You don't get on horses unless you know they're prepared. You know they're prepared because you've studied, you've read, you've watched videos, you've watched people do bad things, you watch good things. You've learned how to read and understand horses and interpret their fear and their body language. Therefore, you know how to protect yourself and you don't have to rely on me or anyone else. Hope that helps. We'll end that there. Horsey, even though you're being treated bad, you're a good boy.